Welcome to PSM Perfect Solution Math. I'm your tutor Sumant PF. Today we are going to learn the introduction to trigonometry in that exercise 11.2, the 10th syllabus. So here the question is, evaluate the following. They have given in that the first one sine 60 degree tan cos 30 degree plus sine 30 degree into cos 60 degree. That is the first question. Similarly, in the first one, the second one, we have 2 tan square 45 degree plus cos square 30 degree minus sine square 60 degree. This is the second question. Similarly, we have the third one, cos 45 degree divided by secant 30, cosecant 30. And the fourth one, similarly, you can see sine 30 tan 45 cosecant, that is minus cosecant 60 divided by secant 30 plus cos 60 plus cot 45 degree. And last one is we're having that 5 cos square 60 plus 4 secant square 30 minus tan square 45 divided by sine square 30 plus cos square 30 degree. So this is the all 5 questions from the first one. In this video we are going to solve the first 3, and next 4th and 5th one we will solve in the next video. So link I will give in the description, or you can click this icon mark so that you can, from there you can check that video also. So let us start with the first one. So first one question, I will write it down here. So I will make one line here and I will write down the first one. So the first one question here we have is, that is the sine 60 degree, then we have cos 30 degree, then we have sine 30 degree, and lastly we have cos 60 degree. So this is the first question what actually they have mentioned. When they have given the question for you, first we have to see the value of that sine 60 they have given and cos 30, sine 30 and cos 60. So that value we have to substitute. So you know the table, how it will be, and you know how to calculate that value also. So sine, cos, tan, cot and secant and cosecant, all the 0 to 90 degree standard angles what we know, that we have know already. If you don't know the table, just you can copy it from here, that I will write it down, that is the 0 degree. Importantly, we need that sine one angle, sine all the value of that one angle. If you know that sine all the values, then you can go for the other 5 easily. So first one we need only sine of the value. So sine 0 degree already we know 0, then the 30 degree, the half. Then we have 1 by root 2, root 3 by 2, and lastly we have 1. So this is the value of sine, and a cos already you know, it is a reciprocal of it. So it will be 1 here, root 3 by 2, then 1 by root 2, and half, and 0. How we have gone like this way in the sine, we have to come like this way in a cos. So similarly we have the tan, so tan is nothing but we have to divide the sine and cos. So sine and cos, if we'll divide it, 0 by 1 is 0, then the 2 get cancelled, so 1 by root 3 we are going to have, then here all everything will get cancelled, 1 we have, and here we will have root 3, and here not defined. Okay, these are the 3 angles is enough, because when we are going for the cot, reverse of the tan. When you are going for the secant, it is the reverse of the cos, and when you are going for sine, it is the reverse of the cosecant. So directly we can write it down. If you want, quickly I will write down. So it will be not defined first, then we will have root 3, then we will have 1 again, and 1 by root 3 again, and lastly again 0 we have, so 0. So you can write it down. So quickly, secant we have, secant are similar, the cos reciprocal, 1 by 1 is 1, and it is 2 by root 3, here root 2 by 1, here we have 2 by 1 is 2, and lastly here you see 1 divided by 0, that cannot be found, so it is not defined, and lastly we have cosecant. So we have the cosecant over here, so I hope you can find it, the cosecant. So if it is not visible to you, no problem, I will write it on little bit this side. So I hope you can check that this is a sine. You might have know this sine. I will write little bit aside because some problem we have in the screen. So here it is a tan. This is a cot we have, and this is secant. I hope you know it is visible to you. Now I will write on cosecant. Cosecant, when it will come, it is a reciprocal of this, so not defined. Then we have 2. Then we have here we have root 2 by 1 is root 2 only. Lastly we will have 2 by root 3, and lastly we have 1. So this is the value what you have to remember. I hope it is visible to you. If it is not visible, don't worry, I will put it this on the screen also. Okay, I will display this one also. So this is your answer. That is the table what you required for solving all these problems. So first we will go for sine 60. So sine 60 value, so directly sine 60, yes, root 3 by 2. So I will write it down here, root 3 by 2. That equals to, I have written below this, and the cos 30 degree, cos 30, if you will go, it is a root 3 by 2 again. And sine 30, when you will go, it is see here, sine 30 we have want, the half it is, and the cos 60 we want, so cos 60 is again half. So according to that, we can write it down. When you are exam, if this question was asked, if you have the table, you can write it down in a rough page, and you can copy it and you can write it down on the answers quickly, because there will be one question will be asked based on this angles. So you have to remember this. So 2 2s are 4, you are going to get root 3 into root 3, root 3 the whole square. So here square and the root get cancelled, remaining is 3 by 4. And let us go for this side, 1 into 1 is 1, 2 2s are 4. So obviously here 3 by 4 is left, and here you have 1 by 4. So totally it is the LCM. Obviously 3 plus 1 is 4. So you can write it down, 3 plus 1 divided by 4, LCM we have. And lastly, we will have 3 plus 1 is 4 divided by 4, 4 by 4 is get cancelled, the answer will become 1. So this is our answer, the first one answer, that is sine 60 into cos 30 plus sine 30 into cos 60. What the answer you have? That is the 1. So this is the first answer. So let us go for the second one. So second one here we have in terms of the tan, cos and sine. So here small thing we have to understand. The small thing is what? What you have to understand here is, here we have the square. So we have to remember, so I will write down one question, that second one question we have 2 tan square 45 degrees. See here they have given square. So square 45 degree plus they have given cos square 30 degree. And lastly, we have minus sine square 60 degree. Remember, here they have not given tan 45 degree or cos 30 degree or sine 60 degree. They have given in terms of a square. So obviously, when there is a square, how to solve? So one thing I will tell you, just I will make a note over here, just all of you remember. So when you are taking any square, so for example, here they have given sine square. So sine square 60 degree. Means what? It is nothing but sine 60 degree the whole square. So always remember, you have to find the sine 60, then you have to find the square for that. So that is the meaning of it. So let us solve this. So it is similarly, 2 tan square 45 is nothing but 2 into, we have to find the tan 45 value, and we have to write it down here, and for that we have to make a square. So tan square 45 is nothing but tan 45 the whole square. So if you want, I will write down tan square 45 is nothing but tan 45 degree the whole square. So let us write it on that 45 degree. Tan 45 means what? Tan 45 is 1. So 1 square we have to do, that's all. Then we have the cos 30 degree the whole square. So cos 30 degree is how much? Let us see, cos 30 root 3 by 2. So root 3 by 2 the whole square. Remember, now you can see the table and you can write it on, but practice it, it will be easier. The table is not difficult, quickly we can answer. So sine square 60 the hagman, sine 60 is obviously we have the root 3 by 2, so root 3 by 2 the whole square. So let us solve this. So 2 into 1 square is 1 plus square we have to do for both. So here remember, root 3 the whole square, yeah, root 3 the whole square, root square get cancelled. So those who cannot understand, I will write it down. So this 2 is for, we have to take it for both. So it will be 2 square, and 2 square you know what is the value. Minus we have the root 3 we have the whole square, because square we have to take it for both. 2 square. So obviously 2 ones are 2 plus square square root, here also square square root get cancelled. So it will remain 3 by 4 minus 3 by 4. So plus 3 by 4 minus 3 by 4, obviously it get cancelled. So because it is plus and minus, the remaining answer will be 2, and this is your final answer. So 2 tan square 45 degree plus cos square 30 degree minus sine square 60 degree, answer is nothing but 2. So here this answer is 2, and this answer became 1. So lastly, we need the third one. We have to solve the third one answer. So let us go for the third question. So third question, and this third question is little bit, you have to concentrate, because when you are doing this, no, third one, so you have to be remember. Okay, so let me go for the third one. So that is, all of you concentrate correctly. So here we have cos 45, because it is division, no? So some student will find difficulty, because here rationalizing factor we have to do, if it will come the root value in the denominator. So what is rationalizing factor? You know, you have learned in a 9th standard, 8th standard and all, but we will recall it. Let us see, secant 30 degree we have, then we have plus cosecant 30 degree. So looks like simple, yes, it looks like simple, but it is having the secant and the cosecant, that's all. So let us solve. So first one is a cos 45. Cos 45 directly is 1 by root 2. See, root 2 value it came, so whole divided by, again we have to find the secant 30. Secant 30 degree is 2 by root 3. Remember it, here we have 2 by root 3. So all have to be remember, because in the denominator, the whole denominator, it is coming the root value, remember, I'm stressing it. And plus we have, so we have to put the plus, and cosecant 30 degree, cosecant 30 degree, if you'll go, see that cosecant 30 degree is 2. And here 2 by nothing we have, but we can write on 2 by 1, because here we have 2 by root 3, no? So we have to take the LCM of it. So I will write it down once again here, just I will rub it, and I will write it down here like this way. So here you can see root 3 and 1 is the denominator, that is not the same term, these are different term, because in between you have plus. So what here you have to do is, you have to take the LCM. So LCM of the root 3 and 1 is nothing but root 3. So I will write now above as it is, 1 by root 2 as it is, I will not make any changes. So as we have, once again we will check whether we have written correctly. Yes, 1 by root 2, then we want secant 30, so secant 30 is 2 by root 3, and lastly we have want to find the cosecant 30, it is 2, correct. So the LCM will be root 3, so root 3 will be here, and here, see here, root 3 we have taken from here to here, so root 3 already is there, so it will remain 2 as it is. But here, here we have only 1, no? So we have to make this as a root 3. So we have to multiply root 3 on the numerator, denominator. So because LCM we want root 3, so it is plus 2 root 3. So don't cancel this root 3 and root 3. It cannot be, because these are the separate term. That is, we have plus in between, so we can't cancel them. So next, what we have to do? So I will write it down here only because of the space, I don't have much. So I will write it down here. So here what you have to do is, this root 3 can be this, you can put the bracket for this, and this root 3 I can take it up, so it will go to the denominator, that is also what actually we know. So let us go for that. So it will become 1 by root 2, that will be multiplied with the reciprocal of it, root 3 whole divided by 2 plus 2 root 3. So I will put the bracket for it, so I will write it down here. So 1 into root 3 is root 3, and obviously if you see clearly, root 2 I can multiply inside. So if I multiply root 2 inside, again it will be lots of confusion you may have, because here we have to take the rationalizing the factor. So what is that rationalizing the factor? If you don't know, we have not supposed to keep the root value in the denominator, so that root value we have to take it up. So how to make that root value, we can take it up by taking same, multiplying the same value above also, or here also we have root 3 also, root 2 also, 2 2 we have, so denominator we have the 2 2 root value. So what I will do is this, here you can see 2 is there, here 2 is there, I can take that 2 common, so I will take that 2 common, okay, and root 2 as it is we have, so inside will be 1 plus root 3. So you may have got confused here, but I will tell you, this is 2 and this 2 I have taken common. So if you will take the 2 common, it will remain 1, here also 1. So 1 plus root 3, the 2 root 2 is common. Now what I will do, root 3 I will keep it as it is, divided by, whole divided by 2 I will keep it as it is, but this root 2 I will multiply both the side. So when you will multiply root 2 on the both side, it will become root 2 into 1 is root 2 plus root 3 into root 2 is root 6. So here we have the two things. What is that we have to remove from here? So rationalizing factor of this root 2 and root 6 is nothing but same thing we have to multiply. That is root 2 and root 6, but we have to take the negative. So here also the same thing we have to use. So here also root 2 minus root 6 we have to multiply. Remember, I am multiplying the rationalizing factor. That is here we have plus, so we have to take the minus and the same value. But I have not taken the 2 because this 2 is outside the bracket and this 2 is already have rationalizing factor because it is not in a form of a root value. So again, no need to make a rationalizing factor. So now let us multiply. So we put that bracket and see here. All of you concentrate here. Just I will tell you, it is in a form of this. So I will write it on first root 3 into this. Root 3 into root 2 is root 6, and root 3 into minus root 6 is minus root 18. Okay, so because 6 3 is 18, so that is the first thing we have done. So 2 is there, that I will write down as it is. Now I'm have to concentrate here. So A is here, you consider this is A and this is B. A plus B, and here we have in terms of A minus B. So A plus B into A minus B is nothing but A square minus B square form, that we know. So here the A acting as a root 2. So root 2, so I will put the bracket, root 2 the whole square minus, because you have minus B square, B value is acting as root 6. Root 6 the whole square. So here the whole bracket we have, let us write it on that whole bracket. No problem. So now we can simplify this. So the answer will become root 6. And if you want that root 18 can be splitted in terms of 3, because 3 square is 9. So if you want, I will write it down correctly. That root 9 into 2. Okay. So divided by 2 we have. Square and square root get cancelled. Square and square root get cancelled. Remaining will be 2 here. And here we have minus 6. Because root already got cancelled, only remaining is 2 here, because 2 we have, and root 6 in that root is got cancelled, so it is remaining 6. So here we have 2 minus 6, and above we have root 6 that cannot be simplified further, but we have minus root 9 is nothing but 3. So I will take that 3 outside, but inside it will remain root 2 as it is, whole divided by. Next we have 2 into 2 minus 6 is minus 4. So obviously the answer will become root 6 minus 3 root 2 whole divided by 4 to the 8, but having the negative symbol. So this is the answer actually, but again we will see that is negative sign in the denominator. Again, some of them will not keep, so that I will shift this minus sign above the numerator. This both I will take it, and what will happen, just we will write it down here, that will equals to negative will go up. So root 6 minus 3 root 2, then we will have whole divided by 8. So this can be simplified as minus into plus, that minus root 6, minus into minus is plus 3 root 2 whole divided by 8. That can be rewritten as, that can be rewritten as, first positive we will write on 3 root 2, then we will write minus root 6 whole divided by 8, and this is our final answer, because again simplification further is not possible. So here we got as a root 6, remember we got as a root 6. I think you can see this, otherwise I will write it down. So here we got actually as a root 6 and nothing else. So here we have 3 root 2 minus root 6 divided by 8, and this is our final answer. So these are the three answers of this first main, and the third main looks like little bit lengthy, because this is lengthy because we can't keep that root value in the denominator, so we have to do the rationalizing factor. So these everything is the introduction to trigonometry, exercise 11.2, that is first main, first three questions. So next two questions are in the next video. So see you for today. Any doubt if you have, you can write it in the comment section, or you can contact me in the social media, that is Instagram or Facebook. Link is given in description. Thank you for watching. See you in my next video. Till then, take care.